Hello everyone, in this video, I'll be doing a general rundown of gear to get on a Paladin and the order to purchase it for PvE content. This guide will be assuming you're on an established server with gear available. The prices are based on the average selling price on the Antica market on February 2022, so these may change over time, or you may be able to get the items cheaper if you're patient enough with a buy offer. Also, this is just my opinion on gear. There are many factors that can change the value of pieces for your character. Other players may have different opinions, or it could change depending on the spawns you are hunting. I'll do my best to let you know the reasoning why I chose each piece and any further details on each piece I have to help you understand why I recommend it. In the end, this video is just to help you make a decision. I'll list the equipment for each level range in the order I would purchase it, but if you have enough money, you may want to skip right to a later item that is more expensive. Also, I'll cover trinkets at the end of the video, though it is possible to purchase the majority of them as soon as you need them. Starting as a Paladin, once you reach mainland, you should have a Ranger's Cloak, Ranger's Legs, and whatever other gear you brought from Dawnport. Your first few hunts will probably be using a cheap shield and some spears. You may want to grab a Dwarven Shield or something similar. As soon as you reach mainland at level 8, the following upgrades are available to you. Scarf, Elvish Bow, Belted Cape, Wood Cape, Sound Legs, Sound Shoes, Platinum Amulet, and Paladin Armor. I chose Elvis Bow because it has 3 imbuement slots, so if you have the cash to fund your character, you can put a full set of imbues on this bow. Wood Cape is a helmet that will give you +1 distance fighting and 4% earth protection. Scarf and Belted Cape can both be replaced by Platinum Amulet and Paladin Armor once you save up enough money. Paladin Armor will grant you +2 distance fighting. The next set of upgrades you will have available will be at level 50. They are the Composite Hornbow, Butterfly Ring, and Metal Spats. The Composite Hornbow is relatively cheap and could be an upgrade over the Elvish Bow. It has a 3% lower hit percent, but an additional 3 attack. You may be happy to stick with your Elvish Bow, especially if you have imbuements on it. Butterfly Ring can be obtained in the Threatened Dreams quest, but is also so cheap you can just buy it for the additional armor protection if you aren't in a rush to get it during the quest. Finally, Metal Spats. These will give you an additional 1% physical protection over regular boots. You can choose steel boots for the additional armor, but they are quite expensive at 30,000 gold if you are just starting out. Now, we're waiting for level 60 for our next set of upgrades. These will be Onyx Pendant and Zaun Helmet. Onyx Pendant is a cheap upgrade over Platinum Amulet, and will give you an additional 2% death protection. The Zaun Helmet technically has no level requirement, so you can get it right at level 8, but you won't need it until at least level 60, I would say. There are other helmets that become available, but you most likely use this one until at least level 230 when boxing with diamond arrows because of the 5% physical protection. There are a couple upgrades that will come relatively close together. At level 70, you can get Guardian Boots, which will have 3 armor and give 2% physical protection. These will be helpful for you for a while as well because of the physical protection. At 75, you can grab a Gear Wheel Chain for an additional armor over Onyx Pendant, though you'll lose the 2% death protection. Level 80 will be Yalahari Leg Piece. These will be the first legs that are worth replacing Zaun in my opinion. You can also grab Aloe Legs and Grasshopper Legs along the way if you wanted more speed, but it's hard to beat the 2% physical protection of the Zaun Legs. You will lose this with the Yalahari Leg Piece, but you'll gain the benefit of +2 distance fighting and 5% death protection. If you can find a team to do the In Service of Yalahar quest, you can choose these as a reward, otherwise they'll be the first big jump in price on this list. At level 100, we can get Elite Dragon Helmet, Master Archer's Armor, and Foxtail Amulet. These items each cost a decent amount of gold, but can all be obtained from quests if you're able to find a team. Elite Dragon Helmet can be chosen as a reward in the Wrath of the Emperor quest and will give you +1 distance with a decent armor value, but will generally only be used while single target hunting. Even then, we want to stick with Zaun for the additional protection. Master Archer's Armor is our first armor upgrade since Paladin Armor. It has a higher armor value at 15 and will give you an additional distance fighting level. It is a reward from the Inquisition quest. Foxtail Amulet is a great amulet. It only has 2 armor, but comes with 5% physical protection. It is rewarded during the Grimvale quest, the Curse Spreads missions. This would be challenging to do at level 100 solo, but definitely possible in a small team. At level 105, you have the option to grab a Mycological Bow. This is a cheap upgrade, and the bow gives +4 attack and +4 hit percent. It can be worth to pick this bow up because it is so cheap, it can we sold the Rashid, but we'll be getting rid of this at level 120 for a new bow. At level 120, we can now grab a Rift Bow, Rift Crossbow, and Prismatic Armor. Rift Bow is what we'll be using as a bow until level 220, so you'll definitely want to grab this one. It has plus 5 attack and plus 3 hit percent. This makes it 1 attack better and 1 hit percent worse than Mythological Bow. When using Diamond Arrows though, hit percent won't matter because they are area of effect. Rift Crossbow is the first crossbow I've mentioned. You may have wanted to pick one up earlier, but I figure you will get by fine with bows. The Rift Crossbow has plus 5 attack and plus 4 hit percent. It could be another option for single target hunting or bosses, so it's up to you if you want to grab this one. Both the Rift Bow and Crossbow are cheap options that can be sold back to Rashid when you're done with them. Prismatic Armor is a great armor and is dirt cheap on most servers. It has 15 armor, gives you plus 15 speed, as well as 5% physical protection. This is the best armor for paladins from a physical protection standpoint. The only downside that will affect you later on is the one imbuement slot and lack of increased distance skills. This will be a staple when you begin boxing with diamond arrows, and most likely won't be replaced until at least level 230. At level 150, the available upgrades are Prismatic Legs, Prismatic Boots, and Depth Lurica. Just like the armor, the Prismatic Legs and Boots are both very cheap. Prismatic Legs are great because they are first upgrade since level 80, if you went with the Yalahari Legs, or even still, Zaman Legs in some cases if you want the physical protection. The Prismatic Legs will give you plus 2 distance fighting, which is one more than Yalahari Legs, but also come with the benefit of 3% physical protection. Prismatic Boots are nice with the 3 armor as well as plus 15 speed, and also come with the benefit of 3% death protection. If you are taking a decent amount of damage from creatures though, you'd probably want to be using Guardian Boots. These are so cheap they are worth grabbing just for running around. Depth Lurica has many benefits that can help you out. It has plus 3 distance, comes with plus 5% death protection, as well as the benefit of having 2 imbuement slots. This can be a good armor in many places and is worth picking up, but it's hard to beat the physical protection of Prismatic Armor if you will be full boxing with Diamond Arrows. This armor will be nice for any single target hunting though, as well as bosses. The two upgrades that are available once you hit level 180 are Enchanted Sleep Shawl and Dark Whispers. Enchanted Sleep Shawl is the most expensive item by far on this list so far. It is a similar cost to all the items that I have mentioned on this list up to level 180, not counting the Depth Lurica. Though this item is available at level 180, you don't need to rush to buy it as you won't get much use of it yet, but you should be aware of it. You can begin saving to have enough money available when you do need it. This amulet gives you plus 3 distance fighting, 7% physical protection, and 24% earth protection. It only lasts for 1 hour but could be recharged for 2 silver tokens. Eventually, you'll want at least 2 of these so you aren't running out constantly mid-hunt. The Enchanted Sleep Shawl is great for the increased distance fighting and physical protection, but really shines when you're hunting any spawn with a decent amount of earth damage. The Dark Whispers gives plus 2 distance fighting, 3% ice protection, and has 2 imbuement slots. It also allows itself to be imbued with Basic Epiphany, which is plus 1 magic level. This can be good if you want the second imbuement slot for hunting, or hunting an area with ice damage. I still mostly use Zaun Helmet when I was this level range because of the physical protection. I use Dark Whispers for killing bosses personally. Imbuing it with powerful precision and basic epiphany will give you a total of 6 more distance fighting and 1 additional magic level. There are a few items that become available at 200, but you probably won't need them at first. They are the Crossbow of Destruction, Blister Ring, and Ring of Souls. Crossbow of Destruction has 1 more attack and hit percent than Rift Crossbow, so it may be worth it if you are hunting a lot with the crossbow or doing a lot of bosses, but this can definitely be skipped. The Blister Ring gives 6% fire protection, lasts 1 hour, and can be recharged for 2 silver tokens. The Ring of Souls gives 2% physical protection and 10% life drain protection, lasts 2 hours, and can be recharged using 2 silver tokens. Blister Rings are cheap, and you'll want to grab 2 so you don't run out mid-hunt, but you don't need to worry about these until you're hunting spawns with a lot of fire damage. The Ring of Souls is quite situational, and there aren't many spawns you'll need this for at this level range. It can be quite helpful in Banuta, or if you have a team to hunt specters. Just keep it in mind once you begin to hunt areas with lots of life drain damage. At level 220, the next available upgrades are Living Vine Bow, Winged Boots, Embrace of Nature, and Enchanted Pendulet. Living Vine Bow is a great option to grab. It is similar to Rift Bow, but has 2% additional hit percent, which won't be needed if hunting with diamond arrows. It also gives plus 1 distance fighting and has 4% earth protection. You will find earth damage and quite a few spawns around this level range. Winged Boots is one of the only two boots in the game that give distance fighting. These boots will come with armor 2, 15 speed, plus 1 distance fighting, and 7% earth protection, which again will be helpful in many spawns. Though Guardian Boots will still be a good option if you need the physical protection. Embrace of Nature is quite cheap and gives plus 4 distance fighting, which can be nice if you want the skills for killing bosses. Other than that, this isn't a great armor unless you're hunting a spawn that does a lot of ice damage. It comes with 11% protection against ice and 1 imbuement slot. Though Enchanted Pendulum becomes available at level 180, I didn't mention it until now. It gives armor 2, distance fighting plus 3, 5% physical protection, 18% energy protection, and lasts 2 hours before it needs to be recharged with 2 silver tokens. Though Sleep Shawl gives more physical protection, this amulet is more cost effective because it lasts 2 hours instead of the 1, though it can compete against the Sleep Shawl in a spawn that does earth damage. This still may be a little early to pick up the Enchanted Pendulet, but it should be on your radar. The spawn it is most known for being used in is the Otherworld, which you won't be hunting till at least level 400, but you may find some other uses for it. At level 225, we can now grab Fabulous Legs. These will be an upgrade from our Prismatic Legs. They have 9 armor, plus 2 distance fighting, 4% physical protection, as well as 2% fire protection. They also come with increased melee skills, so they can be used by knights, but this won't matter as a paladin. At level 230, 2 big upgrades become available: Ghost Chestplate and Lion's Bang and Helm. Ghost Chestplate is the first armor to come with increased distance fighting, physical protection, and 2 imbuement slots. Also, this armor is fairly cheap, so you may want to buy multiple so you can imbue them with different elemental protections if you're focusing on spawns that deal a lot of elemental damage. Also, Lion's Bang and Helm is the first paladin helmet with physical protection and 2 imbuement slots. It has plus 2 distance fighting, 3% physical protection, as well as 5% earth protection, which can be helpful. It can be imbued with Intricate Epiphany, which gives you plus 2 magic levels. At level 250, you will gain access to Bow of Cataclysm and Umbral Master Crossbow. The Bow of Cataclysm has plus 6 attack, plus 4 hit percent, plus 2 distance fighting, and 4% death protection. You'll be fine to stick with Living Vine Bow if you want, but this bow will be a slight upgrade with the additional attack and distance fighting level. Umbral Master Crossbow will be your go-to for most bosses. It has plus 9 attack, plus 4 hit percent, plus 3 distance fighting, and 2 imbuement slots. I imbue mine with crit and precision. This will make it give plus 7 distance fighting total. Level 300 will give you access to Falcon Bow, Falcon Coif, Gnome Armor, and Falcon Greaves. Falcon Bow will give you an additional attack over Bow of Cataclysm and has 5% fire protection, which will generally be more useful than the death protection of the Bow of Cataclysm, especially in this level range. Falcon Coif is quite similar to Lion's Bang and Helm, but will give you an additional 3 armor as well as 10% fire protection instead of the 5% earth protection. Gnome Armor is better than Ghost Chestplate stat-wise, but you may find it more beneficial to skip this if you're hunting different spawns with different elemental protections required all the time. Gnome Armor has armor 17, plus 3 distance fighting, 8% energy protection, 4% physical protection, and makes you take an additional 2% damage from ice. It also has 2 imbuement slots. Finally, the best legs available are Falcon Greaves. They have 10 armor, plus 3 distance fighting, 7% physical protection, and 7% ice protection. Similar to Fabulous Legs, they will also increase melee skills, but this won't be necessary for us as a paladin. Finally, at level 400, you'll gain access to the soul items, though you'll most likely not have enough money for them anytime soon. These are the pair of Soul Stalkers, Soul Shell, Soul Bleeder, and Soul Piercer. I would first pick up the pair of Soul Stalkers, as these would be a huge upgrade for boots. They come with armor 3, distance fighting plus 1, speed plus 20, and 5% physical protection. You may even want to consider purchasing Soul Stalkers before Falcon Greaves. Fabulous Legs with Soul Stalkers would be similar to Falcon Greaves with Guardian Boots from a distance fighting and physical protection standpoint. The biggest difference is the 7% ice protection you will lose from not getting Falcon Greaves. Next would be Soul Shell. This armor has 18 armor, plus 4 distance fighting, 3% physical protection, and 15% fire protection, as well as 2 imbuement slots. Next would be the Soul Bleeder. This is the best bow for paladins damage-wise. It has plus 8 attack, plus 5 hit percent, distance fighting plus 4, critical hit chance 10%, critical extra damage 10%, and 7% holy protection. Lastly would be the Soul Piercer. This would be an even better boss killer than the Umbral Master Crossbow. It has plus 9 attack, plus 6 hit percent, plus 4 distance fighting, critical hit chance 10%, critical extra damage 10%, and 10% death protection. It also has 2 imbuement slots. This concludes the list of items I would get and the order I would purchase them. Now, I will include some honorable mentions that you may want depending on the spawns you are hunting for each item category. Lion Longbow is available at level 270 as similar to Bow of Cataclysm, but more expensive. It has 5% ice protection, which won't be helpful around this level range really, unless you're hunting Winter Elves. Cobra Crossbow is available at level 220, has plus 7 attack, plus 6 hit percent, plus 2 distance fighting, but only 2 imbuement slots. It is an upgrade over Rift Crossbow, but you most likely won't be doing that many bosses at this level. You'd be better off saving for the Umbral Master Crossbow if you can. Elven Mail has no level requirement, but didn't make my list because it's very situational. The benefit of this armor is that it has 3 imbuement slots, so allow you to imbue it with Vampirism, as well as 2 additional elemental protections. The drawback is that it does not have any physical protection or increased skills. This armor is generally used at endgame spawns while team hunting. Eldritch Breeches are available at level 250 and are very expensive. They are no better than Fabulous Legs, except they have 7% holy protection, which isn't a very common damage type. Rainbow Necklace is available at level 220, Lion Amulet at 230, and the Cobra Amulet at 250. This may be worth purchasing depending on your funds and which spawns you are hunting. Rainbow Necklace is the cheapest and comes with 2 armor, 3% physical protection, 6% fire protection, and additional 5% damage from ice. Lion Amulet has 3 armor, 3% physical protection, and 7% ice protection. The Cobra Amulet is very expensive. It has 4 armor and 9% death protection. This amulet is better suited for PvP. Jungle Quiver is available at level 150 and has no benefit except for an additional 2 slots to carry arrows. Eldritch Quiver is absurdly expensive and only gives perfect shot plus 20 at range 4, as well as the additional 2 slots. The trinkets available are Moon Mirror, Starlight Vial, Sun Catcher, Lit Torch, and Bone Fiddle. These can all be obtained from quests, but the first 3 listed are quite cheap and are obtained early in the Threatened Dreams quest. Starlight Vial gives 5% protection against Mana Drain, Moon Mirror gives 5% protection against Death, while Suncatcher gives 5% protection against Fire. Lit Torch is obtained in the Grimbale quest during the An Ancient Feud missions. This item is not sellable in the market and gives 2% holy protection. The Bone Fiddle is the most expensive by far because it's obtained in the True Azura area of the Secret Library quest. It provides 5% protection against Life Drain. There is no particular level you will need these for. Just pick them up when you begin hunting spawns with these damage types and have the funds available. Hopefully, this can give you some insight into Paladin gear and which items are worth purchasing in which order. As I mentioned previously, this is just my opinion, some of these items may become more or less valuable depending on the spawns you hunt, if you are solo or with a team, and the cost of them on your servers. If you have any questions, just ask in the comments below, and I'll do my best to give some suggestions, maybe others will too. Thanks for watching, and happy hunting!